So this is the first time I ever rode a motorcycle my whole entire life right here. I'll never forget it. I had to play rock, paper, scissors with my brother to see who was going to ride first, and I lost, right? Mm-hmm. And so the picture tells it all, dude. Like, my brother's over here, and he's so happy. Like, look at Jimmy's got to ride first. And I'm crying, I was screaming, I was so scared, dude. And my dad just telling me, like, just grab the bars, grab the bars. And I was so scared, dude. I didn't know what, I think we were three or four right there. That was my very first motorcycle ride, dude. I think it would be cool if you guys got up to speed past the tree line, and then I'll come up and I'll meet you guys, like as you're coming, I'll meet you guys in the corner and then get it into a wheelie. Bikes is all sensory overload, you know, you're getting sounds, vibration, you're getting, you know, the smells even, like everything while you're riding, it's such a sensory overload, and music is a different version of that, you know, it's just, you're making a song with it instead of trying to navigate, you know, through jumps and all this other stuff. That's why I like playing music, dude, is because you can really get across things that you can't explain, and other people connect with it, they'll like it, they'll feel those same things. For example, when I made the Grammy song, I ran out of words to say, and at that point all I had was the guitar and the piano, and so that's me expressing things I can't even put into words. I think that's why everybody likes music, though. It's a universal language. Growing up, my grandpa always told me that his dad was a musician, and I never paid attention to it until I got older. And then now, let's see, like 20 years ago, my Uncle Tom, he took a bunch of old recordings of my great-grandpa, and he had them mastered, and he made a CD out of it. He was a musician, my great-grandpa. And then his son, which is my grandpa, he was the dirt bike rider. He's the one that got into dirt bikes, raced motocross, raced desert, did all that hot rodding guy. Look at this one, dude. This is in Torrance. This is my grandpa teaching my uncle how to pop a wheelie. So he'd tell him to just like click it into first gear and rev the bike and then dump it, you know, like drop the shifter. And he would stand there, and when he'd loop out, he'd catch him. That's classic right there, you know. That's my great grandma Irene. So that's my grandpa, that's his mom. And she didn't ride, but she was posing. She was a good sport, and she was posing for the picture. This one's funny too. I always got a kick out of this. That's my mom and my dad. And then it's Heidi and me up here. But yeah, my mom's barefoot too. She's running amok. Yeah, that's my dad right there. And that's the number 88. That's what I kind of took his number. I used to be 47, because I was born at 10:47. And my twin brother David was born at 10:41, so he was 41. And then what's 41 plus 47? It's 88. It's super weird. My sister was born in 1988. You want to know another weird one? 88 keys on a piano. This piano right here is called the MX-88. Motocross 8, like what? But yeah, 88 keys on a piano. What does it all mean? I don't know. These are the real cool ones. That's my mom. She used to jump bigger than some of my dad's friends, dude. That's what I heard. Yeah, and then this one's good. No helmet on. Mom out launching it. But yeah, so now that I'm older, I started researching the family and realizing, holy crap, like there's all these parallels in my family as far as music and motorcycle riding goes. And family means everything to me, as you can tell. Like, you just start realizing that we have so much in common. Alrighty, we're getting ready to pull the old bike out. Let's check this out. Yeah. This is where we keep all the good bikes. And this is the one we're gonna be trying to get running right here.
Hey, what year is this?
63.
63? Okay.
It's funny too, because a lot of this stuff in here, it's been in our family for a long time, you know? Like, my dad raced that when he was 16 years old. Like, this was my grandma's big wheel. And then, like, that Honda 50 over there, that was, like, my dad and my mom's bikes when they were, like, 16, 17. Their little pit bikes. As a kid, it used to bother me so much, you know? I'd be like, why are we keeping all this junk? And then now that I'm older, I'm, like, I'm really appreciative of all of it. It's taken me, like, 20, 30 years to appreciate any of this stuff, so. It's all dirty, but I mean, there's a lot of life to all this stuff too. This young man right here is the leader of the Hill family. My grandpa Joe Hill. He brought dirt bikes into my family, actually. If it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be riding motorcycles, and that's a fact. Tell me when.
When?
Cool. Dude, I could talk you guys' ear off about this, though. This is a real special place that we're in right now because this is where my grandpa started his machine shop in this building right here. This is where we made money to then fuel the obsession with motorcycles and hot rods. So, like, right where you guys are standing, like, I've got old pictures of, like, my mom working right in here in the machine shop, and then, funny enough, like my grandparents, they hired my mom's mom next door and she came over and she worked here. And like if it wasn't for them giving her a job, they wouldn't have been able to make their mortgage and live up here. So it's like if these walls could talk, they'd have some pretty crazy things to say. Since I was a little kid, he's told me, I'm like, Grandpa, how tight do you want this bolt? You know? And he always says, he's like, there's finger tight. Then there's hand tight, then there's wrist tight, then there's elbow tight, and then there's ass tight, and that's when you get that thing really tight. So that's how we communicate there. Should we start it in here or outside?
Well, I'm gonna shoot it, and if it pops, then we'll get excited.
Okay, this is the moment, guys.
Shit, it wants to run.
It wants to run.
But we got that leak.
Let me see.
Let's get it outside.
Okay. Dude, I can't believe it started. That's pretty good. That thing sounds like a damn hot rod.
Start it up, go down there, burn it out, and go this way. If it'll start.
Hey, no 12 o'clock, but it's alive. It's alive.
Sounds good.
I think it's safe to say maybe 30 years since it's ran.
At least.
At least 30.
I've looked at this bike my whole entire life, and I've never seen anyone ride it, so that's pretty cool, and I always wanted to ride it.
Yeah, when we get through, we'll clean it all up, and then you can get it out in another 30 years.
Do you think this bike would survive if I jumped it?
No.
I don't know.
I don't think you'd survive.
Hell yeah.
Good deal.
Thanks. Thanks, Grandpa.
Made it look good, too.
Hell yeah. I always admired my grandpa, and once I found out his story, I'm like, dude, I need to learn everything from you, because you got to have good influences in your life and people that keep you honest at times. So I've always looked to him and my grandma for advice and stuff, and they're really good about that. Getting wisdom from the older generation, that's what makes me feel good.
Is this the first jump that was made?
Yeah, this is the first jump at our property. First one that we made. As far as I know, it's definitely the first jump that I've ever hit and caught air on, you know. And I'll never forget our first time jumping too, how excited we were. And we were like, how much air did we get, you know? And it was like, you know, a couple inches. But that's where we started getting airborne, right there on that jump.